Hi everybody, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to learn how to disable the future dates in what they call date picker. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna use jQuery. So I expect you to know how to put these links. You have to put the links, I mean the plugins for jQuery, and we're gonna start now to do what to type our code. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put here header, I'm gonna close my head here. So if you don't know how to, I'll try to see if I can get you these plugins. These plugins are all over on the internet. Once you log in, I guess the reason why you're here now, you have the plugins. So what you need to do is to know how you can disable the future dates in jQuery. So what we do, we're gonna say create body here, and we go down here and also we create what body, and after that we close this, and we can go here and say what we're gonna call it, input type equals to what we call date picker. We're gonna call it text. Then we call our ID, which is gonna be date picker. Date picker, and also we name our name to be the same. Okay. After doing this, then we're gonna try to write our JavaScript, which gonna give us the date picker things. Okay. Once we save this, we got to test it if it's working. If you can see that text box, we have the text box here, but once we click here, there's nothing we get up until we program that and we tell it to work. So I'm gonna go down here and say script. It's gonna be script type equals to text stroke JavaScript. And after that, writing that, you're gonna go down and close that JavaScript, which is gonna say script. Okay. Once we 100% sure, we can come and say, we start writing our code, jQuery code, JavaScript code, which is gonna be like this. We come in here and say document. Dot ready, okay, function, then we come here, we close and we open here, we go here, we close this and do this, and put a semicolon here. After in here, we're gonna say alert. That's gonna be one of the testing. We test if our JavaScript is working. Just testing. After testing, if it's working, then we're gonna delete it as soon as possible. Okay, once we've done that, we save, and after saving, we're gonna refresh, and our JavaScript is not working. This means there's something which is not okay. Where did we go wrong? It says document.ready function. This and at times you find that. You can see that where we close this script, we forgot the I. Can that be a problem? Let's see. Yes, of course. If you don't close it well, you're gonna get trouble. You're gonna get a problem. So now here, we're going to delete that, and then we're gonna start our date picker what function, then we see if everything is gonna be fine. Okay, since we used a name, an ID, we don't use the class. We're gonna do the date picker. We're gonna take this ID. That's what we're gonna use here. And we say, we're gonna come here and say $, we close here, and we put this here. We say dot. Now we remove that dot. Okay. After do dot date picker, so we do also date picker. Date picker is that function one we call from the plugin date picker. Okay. After doing that, all small letters we do this, and we open also here. After opening that, we have to sell. We have to do what to close it like this. That's the first thing you have to do. Then you close. After closing that, you're gonna. Sorry about that. After closing that, you're going to start writing the code inside. So after writing the code inside, we have to write the code inside. First of all, I'm gonna give it a format. I want my date to look into to have a specific format. Then we put this colon, then we say new. Now we say we put this, then we put a comma, we say it's gonna be YYY. This stands for year dash MM. This month, then this is the day. Okay, it has to start like that. So that's what I want. Okay, since I want that, I'm gonna save it, and I go here, and I try to refresh, and I see if it comes. There's nothing I'm getting here. It simply means whenever you get something wrong, just know you've made something wrong. You can see here it's missing a hash. Tag, okay, hashtag, which so it calls that ID. We go back and we refresh, we try that. You can see I get a very, very beautiful date picker. When I click it, it doesn't give me the right format. Why? Simply because I think I did put this, which is not right. So let me see. Save it. Please give me the right thing. Okay. Display. Select. Still, it doesn't give me what I'm looking for. Day, month. I wonder why. Format. Did I put too much space? It could be something very, very small which causing this not to work. Okay, YYY, triple Y, four Ys, MM, DD. Let me save this. Okay, simple, very simple. And I refresh, get my stuff here. Okay, I don't want it to take a lot of time for us. What we're gonna do now, we're gonna try to see if we can write what they call. You see this date 26, all of these are enabled, so we have to disable them. So what can we do? Let's do in the process, let's do this. Okay, once we here, what we're gonna do, we're gonna say max date max is small D, then capital date, ATE is small, then colon, then you say new, then say date. Then after date, you do that. So the max where it should end should be today's date, the new date. Okay, so let's go here. And you can see now that if today is 26, you can see 27, 28, all future dates are what? Are disabled. So since they are disabled, you cannot click to go forward. Why? Because you're not going to use them. Why do you have to whatever? So somebody has to choose the dates before, not the dates after. You understand? So that's the only reason why we stop that. So if you want to switch off the future dates, that's the way they do. You do it in a jQuery. You can see. Okay, but my format stuff didn't work. That doesn't have to be a problem to me. I can do it anytime, but that's not what brought us here. But it's okay. We managed to do the date what? To disable the what the future dates. Thanks guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video. If you have any question, please leave it in the comment box below. We're gonna respond to you as soon as possible.